I'm on me because that's what they do.
Not that you have a chip on your shoulder.
Just fix this!
Don't snap at me.
If she was smart, she would not snap at you, because we know you got superpowers, Kristen Ritter. So let's talk about the end of last season, because you end up killing your tormentor.
Yeah.
Killing him in a very violent way.
Yeah, right to his face, yeah. His neck. As of last resort.
And how did that feel to you? Because he had been tormenting you all season, and now you're coming into the new season. But talk about what that was like for you to finally say, okay, I gotcha.
It was really exciting. It was an exciting moment for the character. It was triumphant. It was her being strong. I remember when I got the episode script, when that happened, I cheered. Because it needed to happen. It was really a difficult journey for Jessica to get to that point.
Yeah.
She doesn't want to be a murderer.
Yeah.
But that was really the only option for her.
But now she's dealing with the aftermath of that.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering if you have conflict about the powers that you have.
Yeah, Jessica has a lot of contempt for the powers that she has. She is a girl that is marked by trauma. She struggles. She has PTSD. She drinks too much. She hardly gets by. And the fact that she has these powers and this attention on her kind of goes against everything that she is.
Can I ask you about the Purple Man, your nemesis? He used to say smile.
Yeah.
What did that mean? That was really powerful.
It was really powerful, and it was so interesting because around the time that we were making that show, remember that video came out of the woman walking around Manhattan and everyone being like, smile, smile. And it was just such a way that didn't make her feel great. And then our show came out and used that message. And it was like, you know, how we sort of recapped consent and it took away her voice telling her to smile. And so in the end, in the final moment, when she snaps his neck, she says to him, smile.
Yeah. No, it was a very powerful scene. Yeah. I mean, you're known for your superpowers.
Yeah.
So do people come up to you? I was reading that people actually come up to you and say, go ahead, hit me, Kristen, hit me. Arm wrestle. Is that true?
Yeah, it's a thing. You know, it happens at...
Men and women?
Men.
Men.
I've never had a woman yet, you never know, come up to me and ask me to punch them. But a lot of times, you know, we go to conventions or in Comic Cons, things like that, to promote the show. And a lot of men ask me to either arm wrestle them or punch them.
What do you do?
I just go for it. You know, you got to give the fans what they want. You know, my fans keep me employed. So if they want me to punch them, fine.
And do female viewers say, you know, that your character makes them feel better about some of the trauma?
I've had that happen a lot, and I think it's been one of the most moving experiences of this whole job. In addition to it being a great acting part, I've had women come up to me and say that they feel represented. It's made them feel better about what they've been through in their own lives. And then just simply seeing a badass female character like this has meant a lot to a lot of women and men. So that's something that's been really exciting for me. And it makes me want to work even harder and throw my full self into the role.
Is that why we all like comic book stories and
superheroes?
I think that what our show does and what Marvel does well is they kind of go underneath the superhero powers. They let you fall in love with the person underneath of all of that, and you root for them. Mm-hmm. You know, Joe Quesada at Marvel talks about how you don't just like talk about the guy in the suit; it's the guy under the suit. And I think that's what Jessica Jones does specifically. Where it's such a personal story, and we really get into her psychological journey.
Right, that's why the backstory and the origin story are always so important.
Yeah.
Can we talk about the girl under your suit?
Sure.
Yes.
I'm much more fun than Jessica. Yes. Yes.
I know. So I love that you grew up on a farm in central Pennsylvania.
Yeah, northeastern Pennsylvania, about 3.5 hours on the bus, door to door.
I love you were discovered at the mall.
And I was discovered at the
mall. Were you at Casual Corner, Limited Express? What?
I think
the pretzel place. What were you doing?
I think the pretzel place was near. I think I may have been in front of
Annie's.
On Annie's. Yeah. So good.
Somebody came up to you and said what?
There was a scout from Elite Model Management, which I had heard of. Which is a real agency,
yes.
And they came up to me and my mom and asked if we had ever thought about modeling. And I think my mom and I looked at each other like, no.
No.
so that was sort of how I got my foot in the door as a teenager. And then from there, I lily padded into commercials and acting.
Well, you play a badass character, but gosh, she also knits.
I know.
I can't imagine you sit, because that's such a Nana thing, knitting to me.
I know, but I'm making it cool. Yeah.
That's right.
You know, it's a great way for me to have balance, especially when I'm playing a dark character like Jessica Jones, like knitting on the weekends or at night when I can. It really helps me kind of like shut it down, and it's very meditative, and I love creating something with my hands.
Who taught you?
My grandmother taught me. My Grammy.
All right, I have
there
to be a dark character and
congrats
that there.
Yeah.
Kristen Ritter, thanks.
Thank you very much.
The second season of Marvel's Jessica Jones begins streaming on Netflix tomorrow.